For many highway agencies, sustainability has emerged as an important consideration in the way they manage their assets. Sustainability encompasses three key elements: economic, environment, and social dimensions. For pavement structures, sustainable pavements are defined as those that 1. Achieve the engineering goals for which they were constructed, 2. Preserve and ideally restore surrounding ecosystems, 3. Use financial, human, and environmental resources wisely, and 4. Meet basic human needs such as health, safety, equity, employment, comfort, and happiness. These remain aspirational goals as sustainability practices continue to evolve.
Like many other highway agencies, the Virginia Department of Transportation is working to integrate sustainable solutions in the management of its pavement network in an era of limited resources and increased construction costs. To meet this challenge, VDOT demonstrated the use of full-depth reclamation, cold in-place recycling, and cold central plant recycling methods for rehabilitating 2 interstate highway projects, one on I-81 and the other on I-64. During the 2011 construction season, VDOT rehabilitated a 3.66-mile pavement section of southbound I-81 near Stanton.
The project on I-81 was the first time in the United States that full-depth reclamation, cold-in-place recycling, and cold central plant recycling techniques were used together on an interstate project. The project cost $7.64 million and was completed within 8 months. The recycling work was completed in fewer than 20 working days.
Work was done first on the right lane and then on the left. Structural designs were developed using the ASHTO 1993 procedure, and a mid-project design change was made in the right lane. The cold central plant recycling and cold in-place recycling materials were produced with a foam asphalt content of 2% and a cement content of 1%. The full-depth reclamation was stabilized using a 3% combination of cement and a proprietary lime kiln dust product. Key to the project's success, VDOT worked collaboratively with the contractor in developing relevant materials and testing specifications. A unique traffic management plan that allowed greater access for the contractor while minimizing delays and disruptions to the traveling public was implemented. To test the performance of the pavement design used on I-81, VDOT sponsored the construction and testing of several recycled pavement sections at the NCAT test track. One of these sections mimicked the design of the right lane of I-81 and allowed VDOT and NCAT researchers to quantify the performance of the design using embedded instrumentation. To date, that specific test section has carried more than 30 million easels with no signs of distress and appeared to function as a perpetual section based on very low strain values recorded by the instrumentation. The good performance of the CCPR over FDR concept on the I-81 project and on the NCAT test track encouraged VDOT to employ this design technique for the widening and reconstruction of a portion of I-64 near Williamsburg in 2017. Recycling designs inspired by those used on I-81 and at NCAT were developed to add additional lanes and reconstruct the existing lanes in the most cost-effective way. Both projects provided significant benefits in terms of cost savings. For example, when compared to several other pavement rehabilitation alternatives, the estimated cost savings for the I-81 project range from a few percentages of the $7.9 million contract to more than $70 million. On the I-64 project, VDOT identified more than $10 million in cost savings while using more than 500,000 tons of recycled materials. The projects also produced environmental benefits as well. Based on a simple life cycle assessment study using data from these projects, the three recycled sections on the I-81 project showed 50 to 70% potential energy reductions, and the two recycled sections on I-64 showed 25 to 45% potential energy reductions when compared to a structurally similar conventional asphalt pavement constructed without any recycled materials.
These projects showed us that it is possible to engineer the design of high-volume asphalt pavements utilizing recycling techniques to achieve both lower costs and environmental benefits. VDOT continues to look for projects where these innovative technologies can be implemented.
To learn more about how the Sustainable Pavements Program can help you, please visit our website.